of Guelph. I would like to welcome you all to the College of Biological Science Convocation ceremony this morning. The University of Guelph is honored by our graduates, and we take great pride in this convocation. I'd like to tell you a little bit about the proceedings today. The ceremonials used for conferring degrees has evolved over a millennium, and the gowns and hoods represent that history. In general, the gowns for the baccalaureate and the magisteriate degrees are black, and the color of the hood is different for each degree program. The doctorates at the University of Guelph have a bright blue gown, and the honorary degrees are red. The University of Guelph crest that you can see on the curtains behind me and shown on the cover of the convocation program also represents our specific history. The emblems in the crest show links with the royal city of Guelph through the white stallion above, the connection to liberal arts through the book, to the sciences through the astrolabe, and our connection to abundance and agriculture through the cornucopia. The University of Guelph motto, Rerum cognoscere causas, is a quote from Virgil. It is variously translated to be either happy is the one who is able to ascertain to reason of things, or perhaps to know the meaning of things. The procession of people into the hall are also influenced by ancient tradition. The piper will herald the start of the procession of the graduates and the students who are coming to graduate today. This will be followed by the arrival of the mace leading the platform party. The mace is a symbol of authority of the university and will be carried by the beadle. In medieval universities, a beadle was chosen by the instructor to work as an assistant. Today, the beadle is a ceremonial officer of Senate. Following the beadle and mace is the vice chancellor, members of the administration and the honorees, fellows of the university, members of the board and Senate, and members of faculty and staff. The degrees will be conferred in the order that you see in your program. The degrees are separated by categories representing the specific degree being awarded within the college. We will begin with doctorates and magisteriates, followed by the baccalaureate degrees. The name reader will present scholars to the vice chancellor by degree category. As the name of each student is called, the beadle will place a hood over the recipient's shoulders. This moment will be videoed, and technology willing, there will be a simultaneous live cast of the event to allow family members and friends to watch from a distance. The vice chancellor will greet each student at center stage and a photograph will be taken. We understand the joy and excitement accompanying such an auspicious occasion, but we ask that you hold your applause until after each group of graduates has crossed the stage. There will be an opportunity for a truly thunderous applause. Once all of the degrees are conferred and all the cheers are cheered, the vice chancellor will close the ceremony and a recessional will play. Please remain standing during the recessional until all the platform party has processed out of the hall. Our colleagues from Alumni Affairs are hosting a social media program developed especially for convocation. Please share your photos, memories, and advice with graduating students by joining us on social media and using the hashtag GuelphGrad. Finally, may I be the first person to congratulate the graduates on their various successes and offer my congratulations to the family and friends who are here to support them. Welcome to the convocation at the University of Guelph.
O Canada, our home and native land, true patriot love in all of us command. With glowing hearts we see thee rise, the true north strong and free. From far and wide, O Canada, we stand on guard for thee. God keep our land glorious and free. O Canada, we stand on guard for thee. O Canada, we stand on guard for thee.
While you are standing, please consider in your heart for one moment the land on which you stand. Join me to acknowledge and thank the diverse indigenous peoples whose footsteps have marked this territory for centuries, such as the Otawandaran, Haudenosaunee, and Anishinaabe peoples. There's a story of a fellow who's running really late for a business meeting in downtown Manhattan. He can't find a parking spot and knows the deal will go bust if he's late. After circling the block 7 times with no success, he looks on high and offers a deal. Find me a spot and I'll be righteous from now on, I promise. At that very moment, a car pulls out of the parking space right in front of him. Turning heavenward, he says, "You know what? Scratch that last deal. I found my own spot." It's a joke, but it carries an important message. We all need to carve a place in our heart to develop a talent to be truly grateful people. You see, a truly grateful person does not need an unexpected windfall to feel a deep sense of gratitude. A genuinely grateful person looks for, finds, and recognizes what others take for granted, the courtesies, kindness, and compassion that fill their lives but go largely unnoticed. I would encourage you to take a few moments each day and consider all those in your life who gave of themselves so you can be the person you are today. For those who turn a corner on this road and see but blessings and opportunities, those are the people that manage a sea change, an enormous turnaround, as the microscope turns from a self-centered focus to the telescope that embraces one and all. All of you have the abilities and talents that can have a positive effect for the entire humankind. You need but remember one adage, that the people not like us are still people like us. At this important moment and for eternity, it is critical to be cognizant that in everyone's life, there are a plethora of setbacks, misfortunes, and tragedies. At the same time, there is always an enormous amount we take for granted. As we mature, we recognize the success of virtually every relationship turns on one sentiment, one attitude, and one value. Are we going to be resentful for all we lack, or will we focus on the multitude for which we could be grateful? Are we going to become paralyzed in hardship as we lay blame on others and refuse to take personal responsibility to move on? Or are we going to find the fortitude and courage to label the past as just that, the past, with many tomorrows to conquer and enjoy? Thank you. You may be seated.
Members of the board, honorary fellows and faculty of the university, family and friends, and graduates, welcome to the celebration of convocation at the University of Guelph. Let me also take this opportunity to extend a particular welcome to this morning's convocation speaker, Dr. Kelly Meckling, who's with us today. My name is Franco Vaccarino, and I have the honor and privilege of serving as the president and vice chancellor of this great university. And I'm privileged today to welcome all of you to convocation. So to kick things off, graduates, this is your big day. You've worked hard, you've persevered, and you've made it. Congratulations and well done. So as I was preparing for today's convocation, I jotted down some thoughts and translated those into a speech that I'd like to give today. Think fast. We've all heard that expression. You don't often hear many say, think slow. But my main message today is twofold. Think fast and think slow. As a psychologist, I'm interested in cognitive science and neuroscience, and speaking as well as a parent of children around your ages, I believe your minds are different from those of your parents' generation. We see how you absorb information, how you interact with and through information technologies. Past generations might see that as just so much distraction and lack of attention. But that view is missing something. Young people today are able to cope with and process more information and attend to more multiple sources of new information and knowledge than any other generation. Your brains, in short, your brains have successfully adapted to a very, very fast-paced world. We often talk of body of knowledge. In many ways, that metaphor, body or sea of knowledge, is turning more into a river. Today, we are navigating a river of knowledge, one that is growing larger and flowing faster and faster all the time. New ideas come at us all the time at an unprecedented pace. New innovations, new ways to connect the dots and understand the world. We need to process more information in the same amount of time. We need to think faster. We might call this fast thinking reactive thinking. Reactive thinking is the kind of thinking that helps a driver negotiate the twists and turns on the road from moment to moment. Very, very important. But there's another kind of thinking, reflective thinking, or slow thinking. This kind of thinking takes a broader and more strategic view of problem solving. On the road, reflective thinking is what enables you to decide to take this road or that, or even to determine whether the road you're on is the right road. In our fast-paced world, universities are increasingly important places for both kinds of thinking. Reactive thinking that addresses today and helps us successfully navigate through the fast-paced challenges and opportunities that characterize our world. But also reflective thinking that rises above the here and now to take the long view and the broad view, to consider tomorrow and the day after, and to consider the broader context. As students at the University of Guelph, you have benefited during the past few years from an environment that has challenged your thinking, an environment that nurtures freedom of thought and expression and inquiry. An environment that promotes and supports openness to new ideas. One that invites varied perspectives that are brought to bear on a problem or an opportunity. We've tried to encourage you to exercise both reactive and reflective thinking. We've stressed the kind of thinking that enables you not just to provide the right answers, but importantly, to also ask the right questions. We've looked to nurture thinking that is disciplined and thinking that is interdisciplinary, that draws upon diverse experiences and points of view. That kind of thinking is even more important in a world where the challenges and opportunities we face are larger and more complex than ever. Big problems need lots of minds thinking together on solutions. And not just like minds, but unlike minds, from varied backgrounds and perspectives. Now, there's a proverb that goes something like this: if you want to go fast, go alone. If you want to go far, go together. You're about to explore and discover the next phase of your lives. Go together. Think fast and think slow. Thank you very much. Let me take this opportunity now to introduce today's convocation speaker, Professor Kelly Meckling. Professor Meckling has been a faculty member at the University of Guelph for the past 26 years. In fact, she was just mentioning she had her 25-year pin with her she's wearing today. She is a highly respected scientist whose research focuses on the mechanisms of action of vitamin D, omega-3 fatty acids, and phytochemicals. In fact, I took two of those three this morning, Kelly, I should just mention to you. Dr. Meckling is also a much beloved teacher and graduate supervisor. She's been a strong faculty leader throughout her career, and she's a highly, highly valued member of the College of Biological Sciences college community. So I'm pleased now to invite Dr. Meckling to give the convocation address.
Well, this binder is exactly 26 years old as well, and you can see that it needs a little of attention. Good morning, graduates, parents, siblings, partners, friends, and relatives. We would like to acknowledge the Attawandran people on whose traditional territory the University of Guelph resides, and offer our respect to the Anishinaabe, Haudenosaunee, and Métis neighbors as we strive to strengthen our relationships with them. Today, this gathering place is home to many First Nations, Métis, and Inuit peoples. And acknowledging them reminds us of our important connection to this land where we learn and work. Welcome to a historic point in your academic training where you get that glorious piece of paper. Well, I think we still give out paper. That says you have met a major milestone on the road to becoming enlightened, educated, and qualified to be lifelong learners and contributors to society. If we, as your professors, teachers, and research advisors, have done our jobs, then the learning outcomes we strove for have been met. You now have the skills and experience to take that next step of employment in your field, study at the graduate level, or further training in an applied program. You are neither at the end nor the beginning of this adventure, but in the big middle that will occupy most of the rest of your lives. What will you do with this opportunity? What we hope you have learned in your travels through the University of Guelph is that the paths are many and possible experiences unlimited. It is you who will make the future, report on the past, and comment and critique the happenings of the day. You may decide to follow well-worn paths or make new swaths in the landscape. As the instruments of change, you can make the differences in the world for which Guelph has groomed you. As biologists of various sorts, you have been exposed to the decision-making processes used in academic research. Evidence is the cornerstone of the science disciplines. Hypotheses are tested and rejected, revised and retested. The preponderance of evidence should always lead decision-making, not only in science and medicine, but in every realm of society. I am sure you did not contemplate when you first entered this campus that the brand of the University of Guelph, changing lives, improving life, would come to mean an ever more challenging fight against a political landscape that threatens so many of our values as Griffins and Canadians. Regardless of your political perspectives, recent events around the world tell us that the gains over the last 70 years in equity for LGBTQ2S persons and other equity-seeking groups is being threatened. At risk are the tremendous advances we have made at institutions around the world, and specifically in Canada, to increase their diversity and inclusiveness. As a Canadian and a scholar, I like to believe that I have the freedom to express my opinions and make decisions independent of our big next-door neighbor. Internationally, we were recognized as moderates. Some may think of this as dispassionate, quiescent, or agnostic. It is none of those things. It is about listening to all points of view, postponing judgment, acceptance, not merely tolerance, and most importantly, fighting for the rights of others who cannot or will not fight for themselves. These others not only include human beings, but the millions of non-human species with whom we share this planet. The dependence of fragile ecosystems on our being responsible caregivers is unprecedented. If the recent weeks of truly bizarre weather worldwide has not convinced you of climate change, I'm not sure that anything could. The interventions we make as human beings need not be complicated, at least not in the short term, as documented by the prevention of hundreds of whales from re-beaching themselves in New Zealand by a simple human chain at the shoreline. In the fall, I attended a new activist workshop sponsored by the Canadian Association of University Teachers. As a member of the executive, I was a facilitator, and as a seasoned veteran, I thought I had lots to teach these individuals. What I realized very early in the day, though, was that the new generation of scholars had as much to teach me as I them. With the millennial generation at the helm, I see a bright future for humanity. You are intuitive, compassionate, egalitarian, and much less egocentric than the generation that came before. As is often the case, life goes in cycles. The hope of parents like myself is that future generations will learn from the mistakes of those that came before and not have to make the same mistakes again. History demonstrates nonetheless that each generation believes they are smarter than the one that came before and therefore makes similar mistakes again and again. As the first graduating class of 2017, I challenge you to be different. Say, I respect those that came before, I learned from you, and with my new skills and talents, I will support and lead us to the next adventure that makes us human social citizens and protectors of the world for all our future children. Each of you has value. Value these days is so often metricized, politicized, corporatized. What determines value? The market? How does one measure the value of a beautiful sculpture compared to a new vaccine for influenza? Not everything that is important can be quantified. This is a message that we need to communicate to our government leaders who support our universities. The goal of a University of Guelph degree is to create critical thinkers and lifelong learners that are ready to take on the challenges of the next millennium. The focus is less on job training than readying our graduates for a variety of employment opportunities. The estimates are that your demographic will change careers 4 to 5 times in your lifetime, compared to 1 to 2 for my generation. What I know from your experiences at Guelph is that you are ready. You are the architects and narrators of the next chapter in Canadian history. Go forward and make yourself known. Be the difference. Support those with fewer opportunities. Help achieve equity for all in your lifetime. Be the impetus for change. Congratulations to you and your support network for your achievements to date, and all the best in your future endeavors as University of Guelph alumni. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Meckling, for this inspiring address. Well, everyone, now is the time you've been waiting for. Will the graduating class please rise? Mr. Vice Chancellor, I have the honor to present to you these scholars who have fulfilled the statutory requirements laid down by the Senate of the University of Guelph that they may be admitted to their various and several degrees.
By virtue of the authority vested in me and in the University of Guelph, I hereby accept you for admission to your various and several degrees with all the rights, privileges, and obligations appertaining thereto.
Will members of the graduating class please be seated?
Good morning, graduates, and proud family members and friends of the graduates. I'm sure you'll be very excited this morning and perhaps a little bit relieved to see your graduates walk across the stage and be greeted by the Vice Chancellor. And you may want to express yourself in some audible form. This is encouraged, indeed welcomed, but we might ask that you hold your applause until we confer the degrees by PhD and master's and finally undergrad. So again, you're welcome to express your excitement, but please hold your applause till the end. We now will invite the graduates. Mr. Vice Chancellor, I have the honor to present to you these scholars from the College of Biological Sciences that they may be admitted to the degree of Doctor of Philosophy. That's great, thank you. Tyler Adam Elliott. Tara McDonald. Lely Allison Snook. And lastly, Derek Zwambag. Mr. Vice Chancellor, I have the honor to present to you these scholars from the College of Biological Science that they be admitted to the degree of Master of Bioinformatics. Pabita Basnett. And she gets a round of applause all on her own. Mr. Vice Chancellor, I have the honor to present to you these scholars from the College of Biological Science that they may be admitted to the degree of Master of Science. Stephanie Rose Cimino. Natasha Amelia Cook. Nicholas Robert DeLeo. Thank you. Aaron De Silva. Rasim El Fakhri. William James Hilton. That's nice to hear. Sarah Nadir Hussein. Jillian Elizabeth Jaworski. Rihanna Allison Malcolm. Amanda Nicole Poole. And finally, Sarah Jane Turkstra.
Mr. Vice Chancellor, I have the honor to present to you these scholars from the College of Biological Science that they may be admitted to the degree Bachelor of Science Honors Program. Hugh Long Eugenie Au. Vikram Bhargav. Ali Lynn Bickle. Thomas Paul Bohm McQuaig. Ryan Daniel Burnham, with distinction. Alexander Jacob Buse. Sophie McCleary Cameron, with distinction. Cassandra Carnegie. Eric Christopher Sheree Pekeski. Wesley Aaron Chase. Marcia Charlotte Chavez.
Happy birthday, Marcia.
With distinction. Ashley Elizabeth Cook. Helena Cousins. With distinction. Christina Andrea Schonke. Kristen Elizabeth Davis, with distinction. Leo Peter De Reuter. Vincent Inario. Yeah, yeah. Alyssa Robin Fisk. Hugo Falk. Taylor James Beatty Forrester.
Attaboy!
With distinction. Amelia Rose Garnett. Emily Gray. Victoria Ann Gualtieri. Brianna Gill, with distinction. Matthew Marcel Gilliman, with distinction. Joel Emerson Hyatt. Mohammed Medhat Ibrahim. Catherine Ray Johnstone. Balkeet Singh Kang. Vishali Cannon. Heather Lindsay Carroll. Eric Michael Kemp. Victor Allen Kennedy. Gyeong Ho Kim. Alexandra Margaret King, with dog. Matthew Patty Kirby, with distinction. Lane Mary LeBay. Megan Lemers. Jasmine Brooke Lee. Nicole Lee, with distinction. Yeah. Matthew Joe Yu Lung. Aaron Christopher Lewicki. Taylor Lidster. Alana Skye McDonald, with distinction. Reem Mansour. Meredith Jane Marshall, with distinction. Michael Warren McKenzie. Jessica Megan Nelson, with distinction. Robert Ing. Samantha Emily Newold. Angela Osterfeld. Ian Pierce. Laura Jane Quayle. Kevin Wallace Kwan. Lauren Taylor Wraithby. Kamini Rajakumar. Erin Patricia Marie Rankin. Anna Ristick. Claire Kimberly Rosa, with distinction. Jocelyn Jordan Sager. Nicholas Sackage. Caitlin Sandy, with distinction. Reed Scarfone. Kaylee Scott. Laura Seidel, with distinction. Yashoda Sharma. Catherine Elizabeth Scoot. Shannon Spruill, with distinction. Robin Dawn Stroud, with distinction. Robert Sullivan. Susanna Elizabeth Ty. Jessica Caitlin Tartaglia. Jacqueline Van Tye. Nathan David Teague, with distinction. Brendan Kevin Tink. Madeline Jean Tregenza. Laura Emily Van Bommel. Maritza Vata. Wilco Fairway. Lillian Flessing, with distinction. Megan Marlene Wirt. Evan Andrew Willsmith. Conrad Williams. Melissa Winter. Please join me in congratulating these graduates. Mr. Vice Chancellor, I have the honor to present to you these scholars from the College of Biological Science, that they may be admitted to the degree Bachelor of Science General Program. Edward Christian Komen. Brianna Madonna Blaze Dazoo. Yeah, Megan Bailey Ducharme. Blair Brittany Fitzgerald. Daniel Christopher James Furtado. William Hugh. Yeah, boy. Thomas David Neely. Katie Eva Natter. Megan Catherine Turner. Haley Elizabeth Wright. Please join me in congratulating these graduates. Mr. Vice Chancellor, I have the honor to present to you these scholars from the College of Biological Science, that they may be admitted to the degree Bachelor of Science in Environmental Sciences Honors Program. Shannon Lee Gilmore. Ellen Moore Goodhand. Caitlin Lyons. How do I say it? Cherise Nicole Vialva. Brittany Victoria Ann White. Please join me in congratulating all of the graduates.
Mr. Vice Chancellor, I would ask you to confer the various and several degrees on the graduates listed in the program, but unable to be present at this ceremony.
By virtue of the authority vested in me and in the University of Guelph, I confer the various and several degrees in absentia on the graduands not present. Well, graduates, you did it. Congratulations. Well done.
Let me welcome all of you to the Griffin alumni family, a growing family. This week, more than 1,000 new graduates are joining that family. University of Guelph alumni now number more than 125,000 graduates around the world. We're all, of course, very, very proud of your accomplishments here at the University of Guelph and look forward to seeing how the foundations that you've developed here as a student will support you and will continue to support you in the future. We want to celebrate your achievements and successes and really do hope that you will stay in touch. Remember that you're always welcome here. Graduates, you've made many memories here, including today's ceremony. And remember this as well. You're a student for a short time, and you're a Griffin forever. So congratulations. Now, this concludes our formal convocation ceremony. Dean Jonathan Newman will host a tea for all the graduates and their guests in Creelman Hall, right behind us here on campus. This is an opportunity to congratulate the graduates, and we really do hope that you can attend. Graduates, just a little point of business. Once you have taken all your photographs, please remember to return your gowns and hoods to the tent outside the hall. Sometimes there's a tendency of, you know, going straight to the parking lot or wherever and starting the celebration. If you could just drop off your gowns and hoods, that would be great. And one more note, we're hosting 6 convocation ceremonies this week, and waiting outside is the next group of families who are, of course, eager to see their graduates cross the stage. And to help us prepare the hall for this next group, if you could please exit through the doors to the right and left of the stage. Thank you for your cooperation with that. And now, final words, convocation is dismissed. Thank you.